Today's skin tip, how to keep your skin glowing throughout the day with makeup on. Get your favorite serum and get your foundation and mix the two together. You will immediately see upon application that your skin looks extremely glowing. And if you're worried that your skin looks a little too glowy, apply a powder on top, and even with powder, your skin will glow through.
If your powder products built up a film, meaning they don't work properly, then try this tape hack.
Oops, my heart went.
Brand.
If you wear makeup, watch. Change your whole routine and try this instead. Moisturize first. Then after moisturizing, take some translucent powder. I usually use the Fit Me one, and I just lightly dab it all over my face. Not too much. Then take some setting spray. It could be any setting spray. I usually use the NYX one. After the setting spray, take a primer and just put your primer. Also, wait for the setting spray to dry first. Then just put on your foundation and just see what happens and how amazing your fucking makeup is gonna look. And it's gonna stay on 24/7 and it's not gonna crease. It's a technique that's probably still used by so many other people. I heard that it's been used for like a long time, but I just found out about it. And honestly, look, I don't have the beauty filter on. Try it on you and let me know if it works. If you wear makeup, watch. Change your whole routine and try this instead. Moisturize first. Then after moisturizing, take some translucent powder. I usually use the Fit Me one, and I just lightly dab it all over my face. Not too much. Then take some setting spray. It could be any setting spray. I usually use the NYX one. After the setting spray, take a primer and just put your primer. Also, wait for the setting spray to dry first. Then just put on your foundation and just see what happens and how amazing your fucking makeup is gonna look, and it's gonna stay on 24/7 and it's not gonna crease.
Nothing phony, don't hate on me. What you get is what you see.
Don't be fooled by the rocks that I got. I'm still Jenny from the block. Used to have a little, now I have a lot. No matter where I go, I know where I came from. Don't be fooled by.
I'm gonna show you guys a quick makeup hack if you think you ran out of like lip gloss, matte lip gloss, mascara, eyeliner. Usually you could do this with all of that, so.
As you can see, when I put it in there, like, nothing comes out right. But there's this little spot right there, that top little part. You're gonna get some tweezers and pop it out like that. Now look, bitch. All of that product, you could do it with mascara. Anything that has that little top, you could do it.
There you go. Heart been broke so many times. I don't know what to believe. Mama say it's my fault. It's my fault. I wear my heart.
So when you get new lashes, they're always stuck to this palette thing here, and it leaves a sticky residue. Like that. Now you could try to pick it off, but this could damage the lashes. So take a new colored and dab it along the band like so. And see? No longer sticky.
If you wear makeup, watch. Change your whole routine and try this instead. Moisturize first. Then after moisturizing, take some translucent powder. I usually use the Fit Me one, and I just lightly dab it all over my face. Not too much. Then take some setting spray. It could be any setting spray. I usually use the NYX one. After the setting spray, take a primer and just put your primer. Also, wait for the setting spray to dry first. Then just put on your foundation and just see what happens and how amazing your fucking makeup is gonna look.
So I'm gonna try this little powder hack that y'all's been doing under your foundation. I am a makeup artist and it goes against every rule I've ever been taught. So we're just gonna, already did my skincare. I'm just gonna pop this on in a light layer with a fluffy brush. The Supreme. Just a pea size. Right. So it doesn't look bad, but I'm gonna do the rest of my face and then check back in and see if it turns out any different than normal. So I definitely think it turned out well. I don't have a whole lot of texture normally, so it's not like I'm gonna have a lot now. But we'll check in later.
If you are shaky-handed, love makeup, and want to know an easy way to do glitter eyeliner, keep on watching. Some of my favorite liquid eyeliners, glitter eyeliners, are the Stila ones or the I Heart Revolution Fantasy Eyeliners, and I find them really hard to apply, one because of the applicators and two because I'm not steady handed. If you're the same, take a lip brush, like a Morph lip brush like this one. Take some eyelash glue, put some eyelash glue on your finger and run that through the hairs on the brush, like so, and bring them all to a point. Make it as thin as possible and straight as possible. Then when it dries, it should look something like this. You have no stray hairs and it's pretty solid, but also very flexible enough for you to draw a glitter eyeliner, a thin glitter eyeliner, without the struggle. You're welcome.
So I just added moisturizer and translucent powder on my face, and now we're gonna add my foundation and see if this trick works.
This is the final look. What do you guys think?
How to make your lashes wispy. Grab a spoolie like this one. Then you're gonna start doing it like these. Separate them like that. Before, after.
If you wear makeup, watch. Change your whole routine and try this instead. Moisturize first. Then after moisturizing, take some translucent powder. I usually use the Fit Me one, and I just lightly dab it all over my face. Not too much. Then take some setting spray. It could be any setting spray. I usually use the NYX one. After the setting spray, take a primer and just put your primer. Also, wait for the setting spray to dry first. Then just put on your foundation and just see what happens and how amazing your fucking makeup is gonna look. And it's gonna stay on 24/7 and it's not gonna crease. It's a technique that's probably still used by so many other people. I heard that it's been used for like a long time, but I just found out about it. And honestly, look. I don't have the beauty filter on. Try it on you and let me know if it works. If you wear makeup, watch. Change your whole routine and try this instead. Moisturize first. Then after moisturizing, take some translucent powder. I usually use the Fit Me one, and I just lightly dab it all over my face. Not too much. Then take some setting spray. It could be any setting spray. I usually use the NYX one. After the setting spray, take a primer and just put your primer. Also, wait for the setting spray to dry first. Then just put on your foundation and just see what happens and how amazing your fucking makeup is gonna look. And it's gonna stay on 24/7 and it's not gonna crease. It's a technique that's probably still used by so many other people. I heard that it's been used for like a long time, but I just found out about it. And honestly, look, I don't have the beauty filter on. Try it on you and let me know if it works. If you wear makeup, watch. Change your whole routine and try this instead. Moisturize first. Then after moisturizing, take some translucent powder. I usually use the Fit Me one, and I just lightly dab it all over my face. Not too much. Then take some setting spray. It could be any setting spray. I usually use the NYX one. After the setting spray, take a primer and just put your primer. Also, wait for the setting spray to dry first. Then just put on your foundation and just see what happens and how amazing your fucking makeup is gonna look. And it's gonna stay on 24/7 and it's not gonna crease. If you wear makeup, watch. Change your whole routine and try this instead. Moisturize first. Then after moisturizing, take some translucent powder. I usually use the Fit Me one, and I just lightly dab it all over my face. Not too much. Then take some setting spray. It could be any setting spray. I usually use the NYX one. After the setting spray, take a primer and just put your primer. Also, wait for the setting spray to dry first. Then just put on your foundation and just see what happens and how amazing your fucking makeup is gonna look. We'll be right back. you wear makeup, watch. Change your whole routine and try this instead. Moisturize first. Then after moisturizing, take some translucent powder. I usually use the Fit Me one, and I just lightly dab it all over my face. Not too much. Then take some setting spray. It could be any setting spray. I usually use the NYX one. After the setting spray, take a primer and just put your primer. Also, wait for the setting spray to dry first. Then just put on your foundation and just see what happens and how amazing your fucking makeup is gonna look. And it's gonna stay on 24/7 and it's not gonna crease. It's a technique that's probably still used by so many other people. I heard that it's been used for like...
This is part two about the whole concealer and how we can make it not get cakey and greasy. Brought you guys in real close and I took the beauty filter off. So you can already see this is the heavier eye. You see that fold? That one's doing it a little bit too. It's my natural fold, so it's gonna go, but I'm gonna show you how to powder it so this doesn't happen. This, even if I powder that, that will still happen, I promise. Once I have it all blended out, I take my Charlotte Tilbury Flawless Finish Powder and I put it on a Morphe M504 and I start to gently press and sweep inward with the powder. This is no beauty filter again, all zoomed in, and you can see it's so much smoother. This side, same thing, I powdered. It's smoother, but I still see the crease. I do this on all of my personal clients, and that is one way a makeup artist prevents creasing.
Girls, I'm about to change your life. Do you knock everything off your counters when you straighten your hair? Do you have one of these on your straightener?
Take this and attach it to your sink. Voila,
no more knocking everything over.
Here's how to get the ultimate glowy makeup. First, start using cream products as contour, highlight, blush, and blend. Then, iconic London highlighter drops are insane. You need a popping gloss and finish with a glowy setting spray.
Let's compare the coverage.
Okay, I'm really red and I have a lot of freckles. The top one is Huda Beauty, the bottom one is Makeup Revolution. $40 versus $12, which one do you like better? Why don't you say shh?
Make-up Hack.
Damit der Eyeshadow nicht so krass unterm Auge krümelt, gehe mit dem Pinsel in den Lidschatten und sprühe den Pinsel dann mit Fixing Spray an. Du wirst sehen, die Farbe ist intensiver und es krümelt nicht mehr. Das gleiche kannst du auch für Highlighter machen.
Hope you guys liked this video and found it helpful. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. It does help support us, and let's know what videos you guys want to see.